Next on our countdown, a side-scrolling classic that gamers and goth kids can both agree on.
What is your business here?
Our number 35 video game of all time is Castlevania, Symphony of the Night.
I will play that game, I will beat that game, and immediately start playing it again.
But enough talk! How about you?
1997 Symphony of the Night was the first installment in the series for Sony's PlayStation, sending a dashing hero into the depths of a creepy castle to battle evil priests, giant bats, and Dracula himself.
Grant me power!
Okay, I love Castlevania Symphony of the Night so much. It took all of the best things that made Castlevania so great on the original Nintendo and amped up the graphics and still made it fun and feel like the way Castlevania was supposed to be made.
You still had your whip. You had, you know, your usual tools, except it was just bigger and it was better and it was more frenetic.
But the best part was the weapon of holy water. It was like great for my family too, who was super religious, and my grandma wanted me to be a priest, and so I was like, I'm throwing holy water!
Castlevania Symphony of the Night was an enormous adventure that rewarded players for exploration.
I'm just gonna spend the next 10 hours searching for a key and breaking every object that I find in case a key pops out, because it could.
It was the greatest Castlevania and still remains the greatest Castlevania because no Castlevania that has come out has been close to how awesome it was.
Symphony of the Night isn't just the best game in the Castlevania series. It's one of the best side-scrolling adventures of all time.
It should be on every top 100 list ever from here till the end of time. Anyone that doesn't have it on that list is a moron.
No, this cannot be!